Hi, everyone. This is Roman Kalyan. I'm the Microsoft 365 product marketing team focused on insider risk management. And I'm joined here by Tala Amir, our principal program manager on the engineering side for insider risk management. And we want to walk you through setting up a policy for insider risk management.
Yeah, let's do it. So as we've talked about in the past, Roman, ease of use and making it easier for our customers to quickly get started is a key sort of a driver for us when building the solution. So let me show you how that actually works, right? So what you see in front of you is the policy page for Insider Risk Management. I see that I have a couple of policies already set up, but I'm going to show you what it takes to set up a new policy and how easy it is. So I click on Create New Policy, and I'm taken through the first page of a wizard where the first thing I do is define a name of a policy. So I'll call this, let's say, a data leak policy. I can provide a description. Down below, Roman, you see a bunch of policy templates. And so this is where what we wanted to do is make it easier for people to try to focus in on the types of risks that they want to build policies around. One of the things that we learned from our own experience in talking to our customers is that it's a really difficult space when you try to boil the ocean. So you have to start to compartmentalize and sort of focus on specific areas and make it easier for people to start to focus on specific areas that you want.
Yeah, like data theft or data leakage, security policy violations, things like that, right?
That's exactly right. So you have confidentiality type issues like data theft and data leak, and sabotage issues like security policy violation.
Yeah. So I'll also see here you've got this disgruntled employees. That's important as well.
That's exactly right. So we've talked about this where, insider risk is really a game of indicators. And what you're trying to do oftentimes is to find that leading indicator, which can identify somebody as being an imminent or upcoming risk to the organization. And one of the ways you do that is by looking at sentiment and identifying potential disgruntlement. So at Inspire this year, we announced an enhancement to our HR connector where you can, if you choose, provide these sort of performance, HR performance indicators, like somebody being demoted, somebody being put on a performance improvement plan, or somebody getting a peer review, because research shows that those could be leading indicators of somebody being disgruntled. So if you have that set up, you're feeding that into the system, that can be used to start up a potential data leak orchestration to identify if that disgruntled employee is conducting something which could account for data leak in that organization. So let's actually choose that one. So data leak by disgruntled employee, we'll get started, click next. And the first thing I get to do is select the users. So again, privacy is a super important pillar for this solution. So we wanted to make sure that you are always in control of what's happening in the solution. So you can choose to select this one checkbox and have everybody in your organization who has an active account in Azure Active Directory and have them be in scope for a policy, or you can be selective and you can select specific users out of AED that you want to bring in and start to do that policy scope for. I'll pick everybody in this case to keep it simple. Next thing is the content that you want to prioritize. So we know not all content is the same. So this is a place where you can come in and let's say you're defining a policy for your engineering organization or your research and development organization. And there's an organization might be working on some super secret project in your organization. And those projects files have specific labels on it, for example, have specific information types, or maybe they reside on a very specific set of SharePoint sites. So now you can define what those are and say, if I see content have these types of labels or this information type or have these come from these SharePoint sites, I want to automatically treat those as higher priority. So what the system does behind the scenes is uses that to score that activity higher than activity that might not be coming from those locations or have those attributes.
Got it.
So I'll leave this thing alone for now and treat everything as equal. The next piece is a set of indicators. So we talked about this in the past as well, how difficult it could be to just get the visibility into your environment, right? So just as a quick recap, you're either talking about, setting up these complicated feeds to bring in data from your cloud services into some sort of a central UEBA or security analytics platform or a SIM, or you're having to deploy these agents on the endpoint that collect a bunch of signals on users and then pipe those in for some sort of orchestration, some sort of analytics. Here, it's literally a check of a box. That's all you have to do. The fact that this solution sits on top of Microsoft 365, selecting whether you want to see activity from SharePoint or Teams or download activity, sharing activity, whatnot, it's simply a check of a box. That's all it is. Furthermore, when you're talking about Windows 10 devices, Raman, there's absolutely zero agents you have to deploy and manage because it's built into the actual product itself. When you have Windows 10 devices, as long as you as an organization is managing those devices, literally just go here, select the signals that you want, and we will pull that in from those devices that you have enrolled. Again,
that's
I can't stress this, man. It's huge, huge value that we've heard about over and over from our customers. Because again, there's no management overhead. There's no agents to deploy or manage.
Now, one of the things I heard is that from customers is that, hey, my environment is unique. It's not the same as, you know, company A or company B. You know, I think we just introduced customization as well, right?
That's exactly right. So context is important. Being able to configure your detections that are in line with the risk posture and the risk appetite that you have as an organization was a key feedback that we heard from our customers. So one of the things that we announced at Inspire just 2 months back is the ability to customize the thresholds. So you can continue to use the thresholds that we recommend out of the box, or if you choose, you can turn that toggle off and now you can completely customize to your heart's content what you consider, you know, low impact risk score, medium impact risk score, or high impact risk score based on different thresholds that you can meet, completely configurable for each and every single indicator on the list that you select.
Wow. Nice.
So I'll leave this as default just for simplicity's sake. Another thing I want to quickly touch on before I move on are these physical access indicators that we're announcing at Ignite. Super excited about this. So we've talked about how, you know, for an effective insider risk solution, you want to be able to get a full 360-degree view of the risk. And that requires you to sort of transcend beyond the digital world into the physical world as well. So we're excited to announce a connector that we're shipping that allows you to bring signals in from your physical badging system so you can start to identify the physical movement of the individual as well. Super, super excited about this. So I'll select that here as well, assuming I've already set up the physical badging connector, and click next. These are timeframes that you can set. Mm-hmm. This is another thing that we've heard from our customers as a key differentiator for us. So unlike traditional insider risk solutions where you have to have a little bit of bake time, you know, you have to deploy these agents or you have to be able to bring in the data, start to set up your data feeds and then start to bring in the data. And it could take days and weeks and months for you to gather enough data so you can run, for example, those anomaly detection models. For us, the fact that we're sitting on top of Microsoft 365 and all the data that's in your tenant, if you give us the permission on day one, we can go in and look at historical activity as well, as much as 6 months in the past. Yeah. And start to orchestrate on that on day one.
And that's coming from the audit logs, right?
That's exactly right. So this is in your tenant. This is your audit activity. Everything gets fed into that. It's a common backbone. It's a consistent backbone of your entire tenant. And we can go into that and fetch that data and start to orchestrate on top of it.
Yeah. And we know from, you know, research like from Carnegie Mellon and Threat Institute that historical context is really important because one of the leading indicators for insider risks is predisposition. People that previously violated policy or doing something in the past that might be suspicious and now is leading to even more malicious type of behavior.
That's exactly right. So whether you're you have a predisposition to violating policies in the past could increase your risk score going in the future. And we could look that up with your permission. Or just the ability to understand, quote unquote, what normal behavior is for an individual requires you to look at their historical activity so you can baseline and start to build these statistical models so you can define what anomalous activity today looked like. So all that is available because we can look at historical logs. That's really it. You review your policies, all the settings that you've done, click submit, and you're ready to go.
Nice. That is awesome. Quick and easy. Tons of customization, tons of value. Definitely appreciate you walking us through this today, Tala.
Great. Thank you, Roman.